And we understand that a pandemic is no time for ambition. It's just the time that we do the very best we can for our people every single day. I told you I was done with politics and I'd make the best decisions we could for our Commonwealth. Let me tell you, not only do we have fewer deaths per capita than just about every state in our country, not only are our cases lower in many ways than just about every state in the country, but our economy is taking off better than just about every state in the country. And hey, we just held the largest sporting event since the COVID pandemic started. We are doing this right. And I will tell you, from each and every economic development prospect that comes in, one of the reasons they're looking at Kentucky is how we've done this. That these businesses, manufacturing and others, have stayed open while we have worked really hard to keep their employees healthy when they are outside of work so that they are not bringing that pandemic in. We have been viewed as a national leader. That's these business leaders' words, not mine. One of the things that's gotten us here is we have been measured. We have not been knee-jerk. We have not bowed to pressure. We have been measured. We have eased into restrictions. We have eased out of them. We have adjusted based on what's going on with the virus, listening to the best science available. And so that's what we are going to continue to do. But listen, anyone who suggests our economy is not open, we just had the best sales tax month for an April ever in our history. All right. So with that, obviously, I've been talking about this 2.5 million vaccination goal, but I think we went back and for seven straight press conferences, I have said, yes, we will be easing restrictions as we move towards that goal. I know it hadn't gotten out there, but we've been saying it over and over and over. And so today, I want to talk a little bit about that so we can give certain businesses enough runway to be ready. So as of today, more than 1.8 million Kentuckians have received at least their first shot of hope. That's allowed us to already start safely easing public restrictions over the past 2 months. In March, we increased our capacity to 60% for just about everything under 1,000 people. We also announced childcare facilities could return to traditional classroom sizes. We were able to ease our mask mandate, and especially for outdoor activities, and take a number of steps. The first week in April, all Kentuckians 16 and older became eligible for a COVID-19 vaccine. As more Kentuckians got vaccinated, we've been able to lift even more restrictions. We've simplified our healthy at work minimum requirement list, and it now applies to all businesses. At this point, only a few industries have additional public health requirements specific to them. Like I mentioned, we lifted the statewide mask mandate for events and venues where Kentuckians are outside with 1,000 or fewer people. Today, because more Kentuckians have continued to get their shot of hope, I will be announcing a plan to further reduce restrictions. And again, we're going to do it step by step like we have always done it. First, May is incredibly important. It's the last full month our kids are in school. And them finishing out school needs to be our number one priority. It's why we prioritize vaccinating our teachers first. Whether it's federally or here, we've always said we have got to put the needs of those kids in front of us. Recently, we have seen two school districts where either the whole district or part of the district has had to go back virtual because of the spread of COVID. One is the Flemingsburg School District. The other is Boyd County with a few of their schools. Let me first of all say they're doing the right thing. They haven't done anything wrong. They are just, unfortunately, the school districts that show that COVID is not done with us. And we have to make sure we continue sacrificing a little bit longer so that our kids can get through school. And I get that we hear folks say, but now that everybody can get the vaccine, why can't we just do X or Y? Everybody can't get the vaccine. Only people 16 and up can get the vaccine. My kids, your kids, and many others, kids that are in these schools still don't have that opportunity. So our next loosening is going to occur on May 28th. That's the beginning of the long holiday, Memorial Day weekend. It gives us the time to make sure we get through these last weeks of school, yet also gives notice to those that would be hosting folks, opening pools, if it's a big restaurant or retail weekend. So starting Friday, May 28th, all events indoors and outdoors with under 1,000 people, that's the same group we had increased to 60%, can now be held at 75% capacity. Businesses and venues that cater to fewer than 1,000 people, again, will be open to 75% capacity. That includes retail, hair salons, restaurants, movie theaters, gyms. It also includes weddings, memorial services, all of those activities that will be under 1,000. In addition, starting on the 28th, May 28th, indoor and outdoor events with more than 1,000 people will be moved up to 60% capacity. Listen, we're talking one more change. This is being made today. Those two capacity changes are May 28th. But beginning today, as you all remember, we were able to ease our mask mandate, not just for the outdoor events, but when a small group of fully vaccinated individuals were indoor at a gathering, the mask mandate no longer applied. Today, we're clarifying that is true both for private gatherings and for business. Small groups where 100% of people are fully vaccinated, meaning they've gotten either Johnson & Johnson or both shots of the others in 2 weeks, the mask mandate will no longer apply to them, even though they are indoors, but has to be 100% vaccinated. That's what the CDC is saying, but we're able to ease it a little bit for those business meetings where right now people doing it right, even though they're 100% vaccinated, are sitting around wearing a mask. I appreciate what you're doing. It set a good example, but I'm glad we're able to provide some more relief today. So again, we are at a better place than just about any other state can claim, both in how we've protected one another, as well as where our economy is and where our economy is going. You don't have to take my word for it. The numbers prove it. The rating agencies prove it. The surplus we're going to have in our budget proves it. Every economic indicator is showing we are really moving in the right direction. All right, so people might say, what's the next step? Or what are we waiting for until we can give the next step? The next thing that we are looking at is when specifically Pfizer is going to be authorized for 12 to 15-year-olds. That looks like it's going to occur next week. Once that happens, we'll be looking at a specific time period that will allow those individuals to get vaccinated. And we can look at the point when that's occurred, hopefully a full easing of all capacity restrictions. So this is the next part that we're looking at. We want to see how it comes out next week, but we will have more news for you then. Remember, this is when just about everybody can get vaccinated. Let's not leave our kids out of these conversations. Let's make sure that they are eligible as well.